An obedient dog isn't just a good dog. It's a dog that better understands how to live in the human world. Here to talk about the benefits of basic obedience training is Elena Miller, owner of Dogs Unleashed Canine Training. Thanks for being on the show.
Thanks for having me.
So when we're talking about basic obedience, what commands are we talking about specifically?
Just sit, down, come, heel, just the basics.
I think of basic obedience as a convenience for the owner. How does it benefit the dog?
It gives them mental stimulation. It teaches them rules and boundaries, impulse control, how to better live in the human world. Because they're not born, you know, learning how to live with humans. They have to be acclimated, and we have to show them. We have a responsibility to show them how to live in our world.
We were talking earlier, and you mentioned that it's not just about teaching your dog to obey a certain command, it's about teaching them to make better choices.
Yes, absolutely. You know, in the beginning, we like to give them structure and show them how they can be rewarded by doing nice things. If they're left to their own devices, usually they make a bad choice or what's most convenient, so.
So the more you train them, you know, in basic obedience, how does that, I guess, help them make better choices? Are they just not as likely to jump on the counter?
Well, just giving them boundaries, so teaching them that it's more rewarding to stay off the counter.
Okay.
But you can give them, you know, praise or treats or whatnot, and teaching them that that's not the most rewarding thing. The most rewarding thing is all feet on the ground. Especially with like jumping up, a lot of dogs find that rewarding. That's why they do it. Like greeting people, because most people touch them as soon as they jump up. But if you learn that they're gonna get the most touch or praise or whatever if their all feet are on the floor, then that's what they're gonna do. They wanna do what's most rewarding to them.
And what commands would you say are, you know, if somebody watching at home is like, I wonder what commands we should have under our belt, what would you say?
I'd say the top commands to learn are just, you know, like the basic ones. Sit, down, come, especially come, that's like a big one. A place command, teaching them to be calm on command. And just, you know, it's mentally stimulating for them also. So giving them something to do and teaching them that, you know, doing these other behaviors is going to be rewarding.
And speaking of mental stimulation, you mentioned, you know, yeah, you can take a walk and that's gonna exercise their body, but they need to exercise their brains too.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, you can take them on hikes a couple miles a day and they're just gonna get in better shape and it's gonna take longer to tire them out. Whereas if you do it mentally, that's exhausting for them as well. You know, a 10-minute workout in the beginning, mentally, is going to be just as exhausting as a half-hour walk. So it's great if you can combine the two. And it just tires them out really quickly.
Talk to me a little bit more about our responsibility to teach our dogs to live in the human world and why that's so important.
Yeah, dogs, they aren't born knowing the rules of humans. So we have a responsibility to teach them. Just like children, you know, we have a responsibility to send them to school and give them basic manners and basic rules like this is okay and this is not okay. The same with dogs, we need to teach them and we have a responsibility. Otherwise, how else are they gonna know?
And when you're teaching your dog, sometimes you have to kind of come between your dog and something that might disrupt that teaching.
Yeah, especially in like socialization, the socialization phase, whether it's a young puppy or whether it's an adult dog that you brought in. You know, you can be picky about who you let pet because it just takes one bad experience for the dog to become fearful. And so just advocating for your dog. The dog doesn't have to greet every single person it sees. And that's actually a good thing to teach them as well. Just knowing that it's more rewarding to be by you. And some people actually don't even let people touch their dogs. They want to be the most rewarding thing for their dogs.
Mm-hmm.
So they will be the only ones that are petting it and giving it rewards. Same with dogs, you know, they don't have to greet every single dog that they see, and it's good for them to know that.
And sometimes that might mean telling your family members or your friends who can't help but pet your dog, you know, you need to give them space and I'll tell you when it's okay.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it's okay to say no to people, to, you know, a lot of times people will just pet your dog and not even ask you, and that's not okay. You know, that's when you can step in and say, hey, he's in training, he does, you know, please leave him alone or something like that.
So master your basic obedience and don't be afraid to stand up for your dog.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, Elena, thank you so much for being on the show.
Thanks for having me.